GE itu sekarang fokusnya lagi apa sih Bang? Kalau dulu kan Big Iron Company itu kayak slogannya tuh Big Iron Company. Kalau sekarang tuh apa?
We are becoming smaller now. Kita bisnisnya aviation, renewables, power, healthcare. So four main business.
Wow.
Dengan tambahan digital dan additive sebagai future business yang masih kecil.
Interesting. Nah, tiap Rabu malam, dirimu ini kan bikin kelas bisnis informal. Yang kau namakan learning during COVID. Di sini udah ngasih bacaan buat anak-anak, kasus bisnis dari Harvard Business Review, kemudian ngeluangin waktu sekitar 1,5 jam, buat diskusi, udah gitu juga mau bikin presentasi, ngirimin presentasi setelahnya. Ini pesertanya juga dari berbagai industri. Kenapa sih Bang? Why all this? Why all this effort?
Kan mikirnya, we have to redefine what is winning, right? Personally, gue harus mikir, what is winning for me this year during this pandemic? It's no longer like what we plan on 2019, ya, untuk urusan kerjaan, karir, dan sebagainya. Pastinya kan terdisrupted. So, I try to set up something gitu, for me. What will make me happy and then still feel that I win during this time? So one of it adalah if I can share the knowledge, if I can bring people to learn together, if I can make people happy because they got something. So itu jadi awalnya dibuat di kantor dan kemudian aku ngerasa maybe it will be useful juga kalau ditawarin ke teman-teman. So if we can have a discussion and then we are talking about 150 tahun, 150 years of experience, and that's something gitu loh. Gila loh, itu kan banyak banget yang bisa kita pelajari. So, not only I facilitate a discussion, but also we learn each other from each other. Saya pikir itu is another winning for me. So, that's why I do that.
Why is it really like a win for you? I mean,
because we learn, because I learn, because I make people learn. So that's winning, isn't it? Berguna buat orang lain gitu.
It has been your spine kan, this learning thing. Dalam kehidupan tuh ya, kadang aku malah ngerasa, correct me if I'm wrong, I may be absolutely wrong, that ada orang-orang yang complacent gitu Bang. Yang udah, ya udah gue udah sampai di apa sebuah jabatan, udah jabatan tertinggi ya, I don't feel the need to learn anything because I'm here because I'm experienced, right? Jadi mereka ada semacam complacency gitu. What do you think of that?
I'm just not that type of a person gitu. Karena menurutku, when we talk about leadership, it's all about process. And a good leader is a student of leadership. That's what I keep as one of my values, you know, to be a good leader, whatever leader. Leader for yourself too, is to continuously learning. And that's the reason why I always feel alive when I learn. And that's one of the reasons kenapa aku bikin kelas ini. That makes me alive. I feel I learn when I give, when I speech, when I interact with people. And that's kind of like a basic thing for my values.
How did that values come about within you? Was it something that your parents taught? Or
mungkin pengalaman dari kecil ya, because I like reading waktu kecil. Dan saya suka cerita, I like stories. Sejak sebelum gue bisa baca. Biasanya dulu dilangganin majalah Bobo, gitu. Jadi aku belum bisa baca, majalah itu udah datang. Aku selalu minta bacain orang, begitu. Kamu akan dibacain dengan syarat, nanti kamu ceritain apa ini ceritanya yang tadi dibacain. And I can use all of my imagination for that. So I have all of the freedom to pan, explore my imagination in telling stories. Jadi, dari kecil itu aku udah punya values learning by sharing gitu, and that's what I keep in my journey of life until now.
So were you close to your father more than your mom then? You had a more special with your father?
Enggak sih, beda-beda aja close-nya. I think I learned from my dad the things that I learned from my mom. My dad itu barangkali kitab bumi lah kalau dalam pelajaran ilmu silat. kuda-kuda menyerang, kemudian kuat, harus berani, and those kind of thing. While my mom adalah kitab air, gitu. Jadi mengalir, menghantar, memberikan. You will get the strength when you, you know, let people achieve what they want to achieve.
Wow.
Jadi those kind of a combination is embedded into me for very long time. Jadi aku kan baru keluar rumah sudah menikah, which is 32 years old. So I live with them, my values grow with them, and they keep teaching me the life lessons through their activities, day-to-day activities.
Can you remember at least like two life lessons that you've learned and they showed it through day-to-day life?
When I start sitting on the wheelchair, my mom itu nggak pernah menunjukkan, you know, kesedihannya di depan saya. So she's the one who make me strong through being, hey, let it flow. If you sad, then let it sad. It's okay to be sad. If you angry, you can angry. But don't stop. I'm here. So I will accompany you. Don't stop to reach what you want to do. You know, don't stop to reach your dream. And that's what she shows. She's kind of like, her principle is to love is to give. Jadi nggak banyak minta ini itu, nggak harus sampai kayak begini-begini begitu. While my dad, it's keep pumping me to be strong. Even he also felt he is sad gitu. Tapi he show me the way. Sini, sini, ayo sini. Kuliah, ayo kuliah. Mau nonton konser, ya gak apa-apa, pergi aja sama teman-teman kan. You know, I can imagine now, I have kids now, right? So I can imagine how, betapa khawatirnya melepaskan anaknya yang berkursi roda untuk pergi ke keramaian, nonton rame-rame gitu. Itu kan sesuatu yang gue sih gak bakalan, belum tentu berani ya, artinya to do that. But and aku anak tunggal pula lagi gitu. Jadi I thought that I will be very very protected, dan belum ada zaman handphone waktu itu.
Yeah.
So but he let me go just to build the confidence on me. He give me the self-fulfilling prophecy.
How did you? I'm just so interested, Bang. Karena kalau aku perhatikan dari ceritamu yang sekilas ini, mereka bisa dikatakan cukup progresif. Ya karena tadi seperti dirimu bilang bahwa gila aja lo, kalau misalnya gue sekarang udah jadi bapak, gue belum tentu ngasih anak gue pergi ke konser. Kalau misalnya kondisinya dia di wheelchair gitu. Do you know how they became like that? Background mereka tuh?
I don't know. They are not educated people. Mereka nggak sekolah, non-educated people zaman itu, they had fights too. I got a freedom. That's what I remember from my childhood. I got a freedom. I got a freedom to ask any kind of a question. Mau kayak apapun pertanyaannya gitu, misalnya, ngapain sih di Tuhan ciptain manusia, disuruh sholat, disuruh ngapain gini. Nah, kalau menciptain, ciptain aja lagi. I got a freedom to ask anything.
Wow.
Whether they know the answer or not, that's the different story. Whether the answer satisfied me or not, that's the another story. But whether I can ask any question, the answer is yes.
Wow.
I think that's the luxury that I have. And that's what I'm trying to implement to my kids now. They can negotiate with me.
So, contoh negotiating-nya seperti apa, Bang?
So, they will come, they will ask, Can I do this, can I do that? And if I say that, no, nanti malam aja. Ya, tapi nanti malam ini aku mau tidur lebih cepat. They are not sleeping lebih cepat juga pastinya. But I just push their commitment aja. Bilang katanya mau tidur lebih cepat. Alright, let's stop watching TV now and then let's tidur lebih cepat. Let's talk about stories, books or whatever and then stop watching TV.
Terus mereka mengiyakan?
Untuk sekarang mereka masih bisa untuk diharuskan untuk mengiyakan. Gak tahu ntar gedean lagi.
So basically, dalam keluarga Satriago yang generasimu sekarang, elemen yang ada di keluarga Satriago satu, negotiating. Terus apa lagi? Yang you apply now to your children, to your household, how do you run your household?
Democracy, right? So books, stories, history, talks. That's something that I implement a lot. Mereka aku kenalkan dengan kemudian diversity. So I brought them to the museum when they are. I brought them to a pameran gitu. I introduced them to art since they are kids, mm-hmm. even they like it or not like it. I rarely bring them to malls. Datang kemudian, padahal malls tuh paling gampang untuk ngangon anak ya. You can have coffee and then anaknya ditaruh di playground and then, you know, done, right? But I think it's too easy. So I try to bring them to pameran buku, to toko buku, mengenalkan budaya kepada mereka dari kecil.
How do you teach democracy to your twin daughters who's barely 5, right?
They can ask, make a plan what they want to do today, and they can ask me what do they need from me, right? So whether I can do it or not. I want a story. So normally kalau aku reading the stories gitu, the bedtime stories, when they are lebih kecil dari sekarang, itu adalah, you know, okay, what kind of story do you want to hear now? Jadi harus gue ngarang-ngarang gitu, jadi nggak selalu gue ambil dari buku gitu. Jadi, nah yang gue khawatir gue gagal adalah penggunaan bahasa, karena mereka kan sekolahnya bahasa Inggris, kemudian with their mom itu mereka ngomong bahasa Inggris, supaya latihan bahasa Inggris. Nonton TV bahasa Inggris programnya, karena kita kekurangan program bahasa Indonesia. Sekarang kebanyakan gue yang bahasa Inggris. Bahasa Inggrisnya mereka tuh bahasa Inggris beneran gitu. Jadi salah satu ini yang dia, acara TV yang dia suka, acara YouTube yang dia suka tuh, Sam the Slime.
How do you protect your children from the internet, Bang? Banyak banget yang ngerasa bahwa...
No, they don't play gadget. They don't touch my handphone, my wife handphone. Or pad. Kalau nonton tuh di TV, ya mereka minta izin, aku boleh nonton nggak sekarang? Okay, and watch.
YouTube videos itu tend to autoplay if we're not careful.
Yeah. I'm around, you know, mom's around, people. Jadi kita bikinin ininya dia sendiri gitu. Favoritnya mereka apa aja. So kalau masuk ke YouTube yang pakai nama mereka, ya pastinya yang keluar itu aja terus.
That was interesting. You said learning. Jadi learning itu sebetulnya apa sih, Bang? Karena you touch a very interesting point. It's not about, karena zaman sekarang itu, kadang-kadang sebagai orang tua, banyak yang kayak suka over ngelesin anak gitu. Kayak maksain anak learning, padahal anak itu belum saatnya. So they think that, of course, it's with good intention. Of course. Karena ya, you want your child to succeed in life, so...
Gue sih rulesnya adalah selama mereka menikmati itu sebagai sebuah permainan buat mereka, it's okay.
Can you apply that to learning as an adult? What is that?
Nah, adult itu konteksnya adalah selama they feel they learn something. Jadi gue gak bisa memaksakan sesuatu yang kayak learningnya kita yang eksternal itu di kantor, gue ubah formatnya karena gak semuanya mau ikut. Jadi I don't get 25 people in the class. Jadi learning itu memang harus ada pengennya gitu, pengen dan harus ada usahanya kan untuk itu. That's why in the case tadi in our class, gue menyarankan mereka harus baca. Yeah. Kan ada effort tuh kan untuk membaca, untuk mengerti sesuatu, untuk menyiapin waktu. I do the same for them. I do preparation, I learn, I read. So why we do all of this? Because we want to get something new.
Kalau misalnya setiap kata, I believe has different meaning. Nah, leadership atau kepemimpinan menurut Bang Henry itu apa? Okay, I can find the definition in Merriam-Webster, but I am not interested in that. I'm interested in your definition.
Yeah, dan itu selalu bisa, boleh aja berubah-ubah gitu. In my latest definition, leadership itu adalah interaction between leader and follower. That's what's the most important things nowadays.
Interaction dalam
bentuk? Dan, interaction, you know, communication, meet kalau udah memungkinkan, discuss, not making report, but, you know, talk, discuss, debate, ideas. So, and it's the job of a leader to create that interaction to the followers, to their team.
Do you see that often?
That's what I mean.
Do you see that often in the Indonesian landscape?
Kita masih memegang konsep leadership itu sebagai kayak anak buah gitu loh. Jadi atasan, bawahan, shepherd, anak buah. you are guilty before you are proven innocent gitu kan.
Maksudnya?
Diawasin, dikontrol, diliatin terus, bikinin jadwal, dibikinin ini segala macam. Hmm. I'm more like Ricardo Semler kind of things gitu. Tapi gue percaya pada people are innocent before they're proven guilty gitu. Right? So they have all the freedom to manage their work, the timing, their plan dan sebagainya. Gitu. And I am reaching them. I'm reaching them. It's a job of leader to reach their team. Jadi nggak kebalikannya, bukan kayak leadership konsep lama di mana you know leader matahari menyinari semuanya harus ngikut dan sebagainya. I believe more on one-on-one relationship between leader and on a dyadic relationship, right? Especially with your direct report.
Kenapa ya Bang ya? Kalau okay, you're like that, you're more like Ricardo Semler meskipun tidak se-ekstrim itu gitu. Tapi kenapa ya di Indonesia tampaknya leaders itu masih enggan untuk memberikan that sort of freedom?
Karena ada the romance of leaders. Leadership itu selalu diasosiasikan sebagai leaders. And that's why all the courses all about leaders. Hmm. Leadership style, how to become good leaders, everything is about leaders. Well, you cannot be a leader if you don't have followers. How to have a good followers? Because research shows that good leader with bad followers tend to become bad leaders. Because followers yang cuma bilang yes, followers yang hanya memberikan berita bagus, followers yang tidak mau menyatakan reality adalah followers yang membahayakan leadersnya. And if leaders not trying to reach out, untuk nanya, untuk challenge, untuk balik lagi, have an argument, you know, what should we do differently, what are the other options to their followers. Maka gak akan terjadi tuh. You never know how powerful power is before you are in power. Kita gak tahu betapa enaknya punya power gitu ya. Kalau misalnya belum ada di power, emang belum punya power. No, like us, we are freedom people. We are not being served. But once you are powerful, let's say lo pejabat dan sebagainya, lo bawa tas lo aja dibawain kalau ke airport, you don't bring anything. It's become a value.
Become a value that is dangerous?
It is dangerous. Then you don't want to learn. Then you forgot to face the reality. Then you forgot to create ideas dan sebagainya. Gue sih dari awal jadi CEO emang gak mau punya pengawal. Yeah, the only I have a driver because I cannot drive. I can drive, tapi biaya untuk mengkonversi kendaraan itu jadi kendaraan disabled di Indonesia lebih mahal dibandingkan dengan bayar driver gitu. Jadi I keep bayar driver aja. And good leaders with bad followers will tend to become a bad leaders. Banyak banget leaders yang hancur gara-gara, bukan gara-garanya dia bad leader tadinya, tapi karena dia punya bad followers. Follower yang yes man, followers yang cuma ngasih berita baik, followers yang tidak memberikan realitas, followers yang tidak memberikan ide yang berbeda dengan apa yang dia punya, gitu dan seterusnya. Sementara good leader with good followers will become a better leader.
Good followers itu apa sih Bang?
Good followers is those who are challenge you, who come up with ideas, who's not always saying yes, who will tell you the reality, even it is hurting, who will remind you of something could be happen bad if you continue what you are doing. That's good followers. And because of that, the job of, I keep saying this, the job of a leader is to create another leaders. Ya kan? Supaya followersnya jadi leaders, supaya followersnya jadi bagus. Karena kalau dia bagus, kita juga ikut jadi bagus.